Session 31 of Industrial Relations and Labour Legislation of 6th Semester BBA of Mangalore University. In this session, we shall study about the forms of workers' participation in management. The various forms are Works Committee, Joint Management Councils, Shop Council, Joint Councils, Unit Councils, Suggestion Schemes, Co-partnership and representation on board of directors. Now let us see one by one. Works Committee. The Industrial Disputes Act 1947 provides for establishing works committees in every establishment employing 100 or more workers. This is made compulsory to ensure workers' participation through legislation. The work committee consists of equal number of members of workers and employer. The object of establishing works committees is to promote healthy industrial relations. Works committees deal with matters of day-to-day functioning at the shop floor level. Works committees are concerned with conditions of work such as ventilation, lighting, temperature, sanitization including latrines and urinals, amenities such as drinking water, canteens, dining rooms, medical and health services, safety and accident prevention, occupational diseases and protective equipment, adjustment of festivals and national holidays, administration of welfare and funds, educational and recreational activities, promotion of thrift and savings, implementation and review of decisions arrived in the meetings of works committees, joint management councils. They received recognition during the second five-year plan. Under this system, consultative committees are set up consisting of representatives, both employees and employers. They are set up consisting of advisory in nature. The committees discuss matters relating to workers and working conditions like canteen facilities, prevention of accidents, absenteeism, training, discipline. After taking decisions regarding the above matters, recommendations are made to the management. It is not mandatory on the part of the industries to establish joint management councils. These committees are set up with the consultation of recognized union of the establishment. These committees are usually formed at plant level. The members of management are nominated by the top management and the representatives of workers are elected or nominated by the recognized trade union of the establishment. Shop Council. Under this system, the industrial units having 500 or more have to set up shop councils in all shops and departments. The members of management and of workers have equal representation. The total number of members should not be more than 12. The decisions of the shop council shall be on the basis of consensus and not by a process of voting. Every decision of shop council shall be implemented by the parties concerned within a period of 1 month. The council shall meet at least once in a month. The shop council must take efforts to increase the productivity, to avoid wastages, and to make maximum use of machines and manpower and recommend the steps to remove absenteeism. Joint councils. In order to ensure effective workers' participation, joint councils were introduced. Every undertaking employing 500 or more employees should set up a joint council at the unit level. Organization of the joint council was the same as of shop council. The Joint Council should meet at least once in 3 months. It has a chairman, vice chairman, and a secretary who receive all the facilities required to perform the functions. It deals with optimum production, fixation of productivity norms, matters unresolved by the shop councils. Some of the state governments extended this scheme to the undertakings having less than 200 employees. The scheme was implemented in about 1,500 undertakings of public and private sector. Unit councils. Encouraged by the success of the scheme in manufacturing and mining units, a new scheme of workers' participation in management in commercial and service organization in the public sector having large-scale public dealings was announced on 5th January 1977. The scheme envisaged setting of unit councils in units employing at least 100 persons. The organizations include hotels, restaurants, hospitals, railways, road transport, etc. All financial institutions, banks, insurance, post and telegraph offices, food corporations, tourist organization, etc. The scheme provides for unit level councils. These councils are to eliminate factors which hamper operations and improve methods of operation. The main functions of the councils include creation of conditions for achieving optimum efficiency, better customer service in areas where there is direct and immediate contact between the workers at the operational level and the consumer, higher productivity, the elimination of pilferage and all forms of corruption, and the institutions of rewards to be given to those with proven ability in these areas. Suggestion schemes. Under this method, the suggestions from the workers are invited as regards improvement in working, how to avoid accidents, cleanliness, etc. The best suggestion from the worker is rewarded and a certificate to that effect is given to the worker so that others can make better suggestions in future. Management receives new suggestions from the workers. This increases the importance of the workers with the management. This is a method of encouraging workers in the industrial establishment. This method is adopted in many organizations. Co-partnership. It is a means of workers' participation in management and is viewed as leading to industrial democracy. Co-partnership allows workers to participate in decision-making. Under this method, the employees get shares of the company and establish their ownership. This is made possible because the share of profit is not paid in cash, but company shares are allotted to the workers. Being shareholders of the company, they are entitled to participate in management. This increases the status of workers and leads to improvement in the attitude as they realize their responsibility and relations between workers and management become smooth. They also receive dividend on their shares. Co-partnership suffers from certain limitations. Employees are not interested in co-partnership and they want their share of profit in cash and refuse to accept share of the company. They prefer to remain wage earners rather than to become partners in the business. Finally, representation on board of directors. Under this method, one or two representatives of the workers are nominated on the board of directors of the company. They enjoy same privileges and have the same authority as other directors have. They participate in the decision-making process as regards policies and procedures. This is one of the most effective methods of ensuring workers' participation in management. Here, the representatives of the employees to be nominated are elected or suggested by the unions of the employees. So these are the various forms of workers' participation in management. Reference.